Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
The SEC is the dominant conference in college football. Not like you really need proof, but if you do, you can't go to an SEC game and swing a stick without hitting about 15 pro scouts somewhere around to check out these amazing athletes that you see on both sides of the ball. A great matchup in the Southeastern Conference coming up. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. He'll take it from the two. Tackle made at the 26. The Bulldogs' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
Thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
It's second and seven, ball on the 29-yard line. Zips it to the back. And he hits him hard at the 33.
Phillips on the tackle at the 33-yard line. That makes it third and three.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. And he's taken down right around the 34.
I think the play call was the right one by the offense. I just think the defense made a better play. They seem to want it more here on this big third down. Offense comes up a little bit short to set up a fourth down, but give all the credit to the personnel on the defensive side of the ball.
And he's tackled at the 41-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. They get a one-yard loss on that one.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Second and 11.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on their own 40. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a D5 on the ball. Third down.
They'll bring him down at about the 43-yard line.
That was a good reaction to the blitzing linebacker. That's what you like to see out of a young quarterback. Just has to ignore the pressure and get the ball out of there on time.
From the 43-yard line, first down. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
It's second and 11. Ball on the 43-yard line. Flares it and almost had it intercepted. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
Caught by the sophomore. He's at the 20. And down he goes at about the 7-yard line.
I'd go right back to him. He's got the skills to make things happen, and the defense might not be able to keep up at this moment.
So after the big pass play, we have a first and goal. Fakes it, and the quarterback scrambles. Loose football, and they fall on the loose ball. Brought down around the 1-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Touchdown, Kentucky! He makes the PAT, an 8-play, 60-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. So our score, 7-0. Kentucky gets set to kick this one away. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 26-yard line. Kentucky's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Fires it out. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 32-yard line.
He's got a chance to set a new mark for this school for receiving yards in a season.
Over the course of an entire year, you're going to take some shots when you catch as many passes as he does. But he's always been able to bounce back for more yards.
Pitch play here. He tackles him for a loss. The halfback loses a yard on the toss. Third down and 5 to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 44-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
It's second down and 8. Ball on the 46. He gets rid of this one, and they're going to get somebody for interference on that play. Let's see who the call is on.
Defense.
That was an easy call for the official and a good pickup for the offense. Penalties will just kill you.
From their own 43-yard line, first down.
Number 22, second and five.
Pitch left. Tackle made
at about the 49.
The halfback picks up a yard.
The sophomore just stuck it to the ball carrier right there. That's a very good tackle.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Delivers to the halfback on the screen.
Nice job here by the quarterback of putting some air underneath this pass and letting his receiver catch up with it for a nice gain.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Quick throw, almost intercepted. This is the ninth play of this drive. He might have a chance. He's tackled right around the 26-yard line. They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Zips it to the tight end, and they make the stop around the 16-yard line.
Well, they're living on the edge here a little bit, but, you know, they're converting when they have to.
That makes it first and 10.
It's the 11th play of the drive. He laterals the ball. He's taken down around the 15-yard line. Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. The Wildcats lead 7-0. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Looking for six, and he got it. Touchdown.
They looked awesome on that play. A well-thrown football and a great effort to get the ball into the end zone.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he hits the PAT. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
The Spartans and the Nittany Lions square off. The prize, the Land Grant Trophy. The Nittany Lions keep pounding away on the ground, and they find pay dirt. The Nittany Lions are on top, 7-0.
Thanks, Reese. We're tied at 7 in this one. Georgia is lining up to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 21-yard line. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Caught, and he's hit immediately. From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. And he
tackles him hard at the 33-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 33. He's scrambling. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. And he's tackled around the 34-yard line.
That'll make it 39.
Slings it out there incomplete, and they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on a pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Lewis is the punter. He's to the 40. He makes it to the 42-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime.
Let's go. Check, check. Spider. Spider.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 40. There's a missed tackle. Good outside run there.
That'll bring up third and six.
Throws it deep. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
Mitchell was the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Thorson is waiting for the snap. Steps out of bounds, right around the 12-yard line. And he's got to be happy with that punt, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, that was nice. So now they're looking at a long way to go to even think about a score.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
He scrambled. And now he's going to run. Tackled at the 17-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 17. Play action. And he's taken down
around the 40-yard line.
Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
First and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. They'll bring him down at the 42.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
There's a strike complete, and he's tackled right away.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
First and 10.
Ball on the 50-yard line.
On the ground, up the middle. Gets to about the 47-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three.
And that was the freshman linebacker who was right there to make the play.
It's second down, seven to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. On play action, under heavy pressure. And down he goes at the 46-yard line.
Quarterback and the wide receiver. That's a big gain and more than enough for the first down.
And this play is number eight on the drive. Just throws this one away. From the 33-yard line, second down. Can't get away from the pressure.
Call it a loss of 6 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and long.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Level at the 27-yard line. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Kentucky could take the lead with this field goal. There was some movement on the line.
False start.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a five-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. And he hits him hard at the 41. Unable to convert on fourth down, and the ball changes hands. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. From their own 41-yard line, it's second down. Here's the halfback on the screen. Brought down at the 47-yard line. Now Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Straight up the middle, and he'll lose yardage.
That was some sure tackling to make sure he didn't pick up the first down.
Kentucky's going to use their first time out of the half here. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback.
So we've played two quarters. We're even at seven in this one.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. No impressive rushing numbers in the first half. Both teams continued to try to establish the run. They were very stubborn about it, though neither one was very successful. But you got the sense at times that it was a little predictable, that maybe the defense knew exactly what was coming every time.
The run game is extremely important. It's important because it's body blows to a defense and you loosen them up, I think, later in the game. It opens it up to play action, but that doesn't mean that your script goes first and 10, I have to run the football. Mix it up. Keep them off balance. Keep the defense guessing. You've seen across college football, the teams with the most balance seems to be the most successful offenses.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm looking at something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
Heading into the third quarter now. Tie ball game as we're set to resume play. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 28-yard line. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. He's hit and taken down.
Quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. And they hit him in the backfield. The offense couldn't get those linemen blocked, and they'll lose yards.
Well, here the defensive lineman did a great job at sealing up the hole at the line of scrimmage.
He fights forward to about the 36. No gain. That brings up fourth and three. Lewis to punt. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. He gets rid of this one. From their own 38-yard line, second down. Sweep left. It's a fumble. Picks up the loose ball. He's at midfield. Knocked out of bounds at the 47. From the 47-yard line, it's first down. Complete, and he's out of bounds.
Gain 10 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Here we go, here we go. Tie right. Four down. Hey, one set. Blue 88.
Pitch play here. He's tapped around the 37-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. From the 37-yard line, it's second down.
Up, ready.
he's brought down quickly. To the halfback on the screen. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 18-yard line.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. First down.
From the 18-yard line. First down. They'll work the left side. And they make the stop at the 15-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Up the middle for a nice game. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
He just put his eyes on that end zone and ran with some real purpose there.
And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 28. Georgia's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative. So predictable, it's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Tackle made at the 36-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. The ball recovered by the offense.
Too easy, too easy.
From their own 26-yard line, it's third down. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it fourth and eight.
Lewis awaits the snap. He gets hit out of bounds at the 39. Wildcats have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team's put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Second down at 7 coming up here. Ball on the 43. Georgia is up by a touchdown. He sails it long. He's got it. Touchdown!
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
You've always got to be on your toes when you're covering this guy. And he tacks on the extra point. A short two-play, 60-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. So our score, 21-7. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Oh, man, did he take a hit. Max consistency throughout this game, really cementing his star status right now. Kirk, this is what we expected of him, and through three quarters, he's producing.
Well, we knew coming into this game, as you said, he's one of the top quarterbacks in the country. And how can you not be impressed by what we've seen up to this point? I mean, he's making good decisions with football, getting his teammates involved in the offense, but most importantly, he's not putting his team in any kind of bad situations. He just seems to be managing the game and not letting this game manage him.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And he's finally brought down at the 40-yard line.
A run like that usually ignites the offense. So let's see if they can stay on a roll.
From the 40-yard line, first down. Quick strike, and he drops it. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He goes out of bounds at the 27. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 27. And he's taken down at the 14-yard line. This turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got one quarter to go. 21-7, Bulldogs. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. McLean again makes it out to maybe the 13-yard line.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That brings us second and nine.
Second and nine. Ball on the 13. And he's tackled right around the 10-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. There's a play fake. That's a great tackle at the 2. First and goal, and they'd love to get into the end zone and make this a game again. They're packed in tight on the line. They give to the tailback. Touchdown, Wildcats. He makes the PAT.
So a 9-play, 80-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Carter, ready to kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Georgia is up 7.
Nice run up the middle.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on 2nd down. Down he goes at the 37. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Complete for 6 yards, and that's good for a first down.
Short throws like this are very effective because they tend to wear down the defense over the course of a game, especially when they get you a first down and keep the offense on the field.
They'll bring him down at the 48.
Number 3 brings him down at the 48-yard line. First down.
From the 48-yard line, it's first down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That brings him 2nd and 5.
Down at the 42-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on 3rd down. He's taken down at the 19-yard line.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Georgia up 7 points. The 10, quick out to his receiver. Big play, and it's 1st and goal. And that will bring in the school record for receiving yards in a season.
When was the last time we saw somebody get downfield the way this guy does? And it isn't just a speed thing. He's simply an exceptional runner.
First and goal from the 4. They're knocking on the door. They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action. Tackle at about the 5-yard line. And this is the 9th play of the current drive. With a sack.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Corner. Touchdown, Georgia!
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield.
He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive. Just under three to go in regulation. Going long. From the 35-yard line. Second down. Makes the catch and look out. He's tackled at about the 15-yard line. And for Key, that's another catch, and that puts him at 100 yards for the game.
I think this defense has got to do a better job of making adjustments. This guy seems to be making catches the entire game. If they don't do something different to be able to slow him down, he's just going to continue to make big plays.
They can't bring him down, and he's in. The extra point. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. The Bulldogs are on a roll right now, an absolute roll. 21 straight points, and the defense has no answer for them. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
A yard, maybe two on the carry. From the 37-yard line, second down. Just under two to go in the game. Gets out to about the 35-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback. Kentucky will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. Finds his receiver, and that's a first down. And he tackles him hard at the 22-yard line. The Wildcats, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout. From the 22-yard line, first down. And he's level at the 23-yard line.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
Stop at the 23. They'll line it up again on third down. Tackled after a decent pickup. So this one's final. Very well played by both teams today. 28-21, Georgia. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.